Good morning, children.
Sir, yesterday we were discussing about the
10th class 8th lesson.
That is people and migration. 10th class social 8th lesson. 10th class social 8th lesson. What is the name of the topic we were discussing?
That is people and migration.
What is migration? So why migration?
And how many types of migrations are there?
Like that we were discussing.
Still, some more topics are there
that were left over yesterday. Now I am continuing the remaining topics which I left yesterday.
Right?
So among them, the first one is seasonal and temporary migration. Seasonal and temporary migration means, according to the National Census Survey, every 4th person in India is a migrant during 2001 to 2011.
Yes.
So the next topic, that is seasonal and temporary migration. According to the census, that is census means population census. Population census will be calculated for every once 10 years. So for 10 years once population census will be calculated. In that census, it has mentioned very very clearly that in India, out of 4 persons, 1% is a migrant. Means compulsory out of 4 people. Means, for example, 100 crores population is there. Among that 100 crores population, 25 crores are migrants. Migrant means what? Moving from one place to another place for different reasons. Not having one fixed reason. So he is going for only job. No. So many reasons are there. Multiple reasons are there. So migrant increase. Yes. Increased, but not as large as in the 1980s.
So the migration has been increased in the year 2001 to 2010 census.
So here, migration has been increased in this census, but not as in 1980s census.
So in the year 1980, migrations, it was very very huge. Many people have been migrated. This may be within the state or within outside.
So maybe within the state. So within the state means from one district to another district of Andhra Pradesh. Or other state to another state. For example, Andhra Pradesh to Telangana, or Andhra Pradesh to Mumbai, or Andhra Pradesh to Kerala, like that. Like that the migration will take place.
So the number of seasonal migrants is underestimated in India due to limitations in the definition of the term migrant used as national service.
Yes. So the seasonal migration, the number of seasonal migrants cannot be calculated very very clearly. Why? Because we won't get the fixed number during the seasonal migrations. Next,
the sugarcane cutters of Maharashtra.
So sugarcane cutters of Maharashtra means, here in Maharashtra the production of sugarcane means, you know, cheruku gudda antaru kada, the production of sugarcane was very huge. So for that purpose, the farmers seek the labors for the cutting of sugar canes. At that time, Maharashtra is one of the most populous state of India which produces sugar. So Maharashtra is one of the most popular state in India which produces sugar cane or sugar. It has 186 cooperative sugar factories. Large scale sugar cane cultivation begin here in the year 1970s after Koyna Dam.
So here in the year 1970, after the construction of one dam, the name of the dam is Koyna Dam.
One dam has been constructed in Maharashtra. The name of the dam is Koyna Dam in the year 1970. Because of the after the construction of that dam, the production of the sugarcane has increased enormously. The production of sugarcane has been increased very very enormously, and because of that only many sugarcane industries factories have been started in Maharashtra. That is how many factories means?
186 factories have been started in Maharashtra.
186 factories. That's why in Maharashtra the production of sugarcane is heavy. A study estimates that about 6,50,000 laborers migrate from central to western Maharashtra for sugarcane cutting each year.
Yes. So a study, one survey has been revealed out that
अबाउट 6,50,000 पीपल, हमने नॉट 1,000 और 2,000, 6,50,000 पीपल आर माइग्रेटिंग फ्रॉम वेस्टर्न मुंबई टू ईस्टर्न मुंबई, आर माइग्रेटिंग फ्रॉम वेस्टर्न महाराष्ट्र, यस फ्रॉम सेंट्रल टू वेस्टर्न महाराष्ट्र. सो सेंट्रल महाराष्ट्र फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट दे आर माइग्रेटिंग टू वेस्टर्न महाराष्ट्र. How many people? Not 1% or 2%. 6,50,000 people are migrating. For what? For cutting the sugar cane. For cutting the sugar cane, that people, that many people are migrating every year. Of these, around 2 lakh people are children in the elementary school or age of 16 to 14 years. They come from here. So among these 6,50,000 people, in that 2 lakh children, 2 lakh are children. Who are at the age of 6 to 14 years, they are also going to work in the fields to cut the sugar cane. So these people, these children who are coming from these families are very, very poor families. So these children also migrating to cut the sugar cane. Here, the work units move to the fields in early hours of the morning where they cut sugar cane throughout the day. So about 1.5 ton per person. The payment rate varies between 80 to 100 rupees. Yes. Here, in the sugar cane, the field, it is a field work where the people work in the fields, they will cut down the sugar cane. The people try to work in the morning hours, in the early hours. Why means, in the early hours, they will get a fresh time, fresh air, and the energy levels will be very, very good. And they are ready to work. So for that purpose, they will go in early in the morning and they work. And per day, one person can cut up to 1.5 ton of sugar cane. 1.5 ton of sugar cane per day he will cut. And the wages will be vary from person to person. So children will be paid very less and women a little bit less and men will be paid very good salary, good wages. So, daily payment like that they will be getting the people. So, a study of rice, not only that. So, this is about the sugar cane in Maharashtra, sugar cutters in Maharashtra. A study of rice producing belt of Western Bengal in the late 1990s suggested that more than 5 lakh migrants, mostly tribal and other low caste people, moved from Bardhaman district during this harvesting season. Yes. In West Bengal, in the 1990s, many people are nearly 5 lakh people are migrating from one district to another district. Why they are migrating means for harvesting the paddy. Harvesting paddy means for cutting down the paddy or paddy rice or the kachiranke. Many people are migrating for that place. How many? Not 1,000 or 2,000, 5 lakh people are migrating. Here, well, males. And these people are of many castes, different caste people are there. And mostly all the people who are migrating from one place to another place are from the poor family backgrounds. They are from the poor families only. So while males from Tabarta, yes. Nearly 50,000 men from Kerala migrate annually to work in fishing process industries of Maharashtra. So nearly 50,000 people. 50,000 people means here only women. Only ladies, that is females, are migrating from Kerala to Maharashtra. That is for fishing industry. In fishing industry, they are getting good wages and good salaries for that purpose. Nearly 50,000 men are migrating from Kerala to Maharashtra for getting the wages. That is food processing industries. Next, last topic is there. What happens when people migrate? What happens when people migrate, when people move? Here, migrant laborers spend more on food and as they cannot get food from the fair prices. Yes. So what happens when the people migrate? First of all, why the people migrate? The people are migrating because they are unable to meet their expenditure. They are unable to meet the expenditure. For that purpose, the people will migrate. Now, what will happen if the people migrate? So, there are different problems we will be facing by the people if they migrate. Now, if the people migrate from villages to towns, then in the towns, they can't bear the rent in the towns. for that purpose they will not they do they will reside near the seashores or near the rivers or near the open lands by putting a small tent and reside in the places. So with that what will happen? Their pollution, contamination of diseases, garbages and all those things will take place. And then excess of population increases, that is overpopulation in the towns increases, then excess of water requirement, all these problems will come across. Apart from that, what are the problems faced when the people migrate from villages to town? Means in the villages they used to agriculture, they practice the land, then the land will become barren and most of the people will go there, and the children who are residing the villages, the children may not get the proper supervision and they may not get proper food and they may not get proper health also. These are the problems when the people migrate. So migration is good only for the people who are having skilled, knowledge, talented. So for that purpose, migration can be done only for the skilled and talented people. And apart from that, the government of India is taking many initiatives, many steps to control the migration. Government of India is taking, it is not present government, right from 1960s, 1970s, 1980s, 1990s, continuously the government of India is taking many steps to control migration, to control the farmers not to move from villages to towns and cities. Why? Because farmers are the backbone of the economy. Farmers play a very, very important role for Indian economy. So because of farmers only we are eating. If the farmers are practicing their agriculture land, then we are getting their food grains, with that we are eating. So if the farmers don't migrate, then they can get a good agriculture package, then they get good products, good agriculture products, with that they can meet the necessities of the Indian, all the Indians. So for that purpose, some different schemes and different measures have been taken by the government of India. In that one is Upadhi Kuli. I think you might have heard. So Upadhi Kuli, especially it is in villages. One not to migrate the farmers or people from villages to towns and cities like that. Yes, this is all about the people and migration, children. Yes, here background of the short-term migrants in India is in the year 2007. So 19% of SC people are migrating, and other backward community people are migrating 18%. 40% is backward people, that is BCs, all BCs. BC means all communities, Kurwa, Golla, Boya, Valandar, BC Kindigosa. So how many people are migrating? That 40% of the people are migrating. And 24% people, 24% people means ST people, how many percent is? 24% is migrating, 23%, sorry, 19% is ST, 18% is 23%, ST is 23%, OBC is 40%, and others, that is others means, here all, apart from the ST, ST and OBC, the remaining caste people concerned are others, that people are how much? 40% people are migrating. Yes, right, children. This is all about the people and migration. In the next class, I will continue my next topic, children. Right. Thank you, children. Take care. Bye.